In this video, you will learn how to master your movement off the ball as an attacker. Movement off the ball as an attacker is so important that every attacker, winger, has to know where to be on the pitch and what kind of runs do they need to make when they don't have the ball. That's more important than what you can actually do with the ball on the pitch as a winger. So as a winger, what are you struggling with when you don't have the ball on your feet?
Yeah, I'll just say making the right runs at the right moment type of thing, you know, like when do I curve my run inside and when do I go, you know, in the defender's blind spot, maybe in behind him. If my center mid has the ball and he looks up, when is the right moment to make that run in behind basically?
There is certain parts of the field that you have to make certain runs when you don't have the ball. So if you're playing as a wide winger, you'll have to make your runs more central, where when you're making your runs more central, you're creating the space for your fullback to overlap you. If you're playing as a wide winger, it's more important to actually make your runs more centrally so you can actually have your fullback overlapping you to help you out, to help your team's attack in general. There are circumstances where you actually would be staying wide, because then your fullback would be making inverted central runs, right? First of all, your team strategy is significantly important than what kind of runs you're gonna be making. Is your coach expecting your fullback to be making wide runs, overlap, right? So that's the kind of stuff that you need to talk with your coach prior to the game and talk with your fullback partner, because your fullback partner is the most important person that you can talk to during the game, so you understand all this during the games. If you're playing with a team for a while, you know your center backs, you know your center midfielders, right? So sometimes you'll have to talk with your center backs, you'll have to talk with your center mids, and you'll also have to know them very well, which means what kind of balls your center backs are playing. Because you will play with center backs sometimes, they just like to play long balls, right? And that means you're gonna have to be checking where the opposition is, and this is where your initial inverted runs, creating a space for your fullback or creating a space for yourself, comes in hand, because now you actually know what your center mid or what your center back is gonna play, right? You figure this out first with your fullback. It doesn't have to happen how you made an arrangement with your fullback, because it's gonna change during the game, but the kind of players you play with will really change the way that you play as a winger or as an attacker in general. Let's say your center back has the ball in the back, right? And they don't like to play to your center mid or your defensive mid. They like to go long, find you behind the fullback. This is very important to know, because now you created the space for yourself, you have the space, and you have a fullback behind you. When you have a fullback behind you or center back behind you, it's very important to pull them out of the position first, okay? What you do is, come here and be a center back behind me. So you're a center back, right? How can I make you slower so I can run behind you, right? So first thing I would do, come forward, right? Check and get him off the position, right? Then immediately, as soon as you do that, you know your center back is gonna play long because you guys know each other, right? You created that space, and as soon as you make that run, then you go behind, because you're catching the opposition center back off position and probably off strong feet that they can turn around. And generally, you know, center backs are slow players. Fullbacks are a little faster. So if you're gonna make those runs behind, try to aim to pull the center backs with you rather than the fullback, because fullbacks have bigger chance on catching you during the game. So you created the space from the center back and immediately go behind, because they're not gonna have time, they're not gonna be as quick as you, because you have the advantage, you are controlling it. The idea is you controlling what you want them to do. If you let them control what you're doing, that's not gonna work as well, because they know that they're gonna turn before you. And basically, in this kind of situation, whoever turns first gets there first. That's basically what it is. Think about it, even if I'm slower than you, if I turned before you, that's extra 1.5 seconds to 2 seconds, right? And I already used my acceleration quicker than you. And so this kind of stuff is very important to actually create yourself space behind. If you want to create space to actually take a chance, cut inside and then shoot or score, you need to know where on the pitch you're gonna have more space to receive the ball. Personally, as a winger, I like to be really wide. Unless I look back, my fullback is overlapping. Then I don't have choice because I have to create the space for my fullback. Otherwise, they wasted energy and they lost the position back there. So if they're coming, if your fullback is coming, overlap, that means you stepped up and then you check inside, then your fullback is coming to fill, right? Most likely in that case, you're the second option for your team to pass. I tell my fullbacks personally, I like to stay wide, right? Because, why?
Space.
Space. Yeah. I like to take the ball when I have my face turned to the opposition's net.
Yeah.
I don't like to take the ball there. Okay. I'm a lot slower, so it's better if I have the ball like this and facing. I've seen everything, right? So I take the ball here like this. Mm-hmm. Then you have a couple of options here. Your striker most likely will come to support you, right? So you can look for quick 1-2 touches and then you create space again behind. You can always cut inside. You can pull your center mid out instead of. Then you can cover until they go back to cover for their position. Because if I tell you right now, you are only responsible receiving the ball here and seeing your striker, it's wrong. Okay. Because you have to think about everything on the field.
Okay.
Who are you gonna cover after? When you're passing this ball to your striker, you have to think, if I lose the ball there, where am I gonna go?
Okay.
If your center mid is out here covering for you, you can come back here. So you have to be there, hold their position until they come back to cover. So that's why we're gonna come to the you actually creating the space to shoot for yourself, but you have to know this stuff first.
Okay.
You can't only focus on what you're gonna do with the ball, you have to focus on what you're gonna do without the ball. In my opinion, defense of a team is way more important first to keep in mind than anything else. Attack, scoring, you cannot concede first. Your goal has to be, how can our team not concede? This is the opposition center mid, that's the opposition center back. My goal right now, because I'm quite wide off the field, you will have two options. You will either aim to go cut in central and then shoot, or you will either go out wide to cross the ball. Generally, the hardest thing to do here is to go inside, right? Because that's where the opposition is tight, that's where they're compact, and that's where your team can create more chances. That's why their goal is to cover the pitch centrally. Let's say you're going there, you decided you're going that way. I pass it to you, and then of course, I make my run out wide, and then I can either cross or send the through ball, because now my job is not over. Because you're, as a striker, you're not gonna stay there, right? You're gonna make a run inside, and I can always look to shoot if I have an opportunity, or the worst case, I'll let you go. Winger's movement is more of a way to create space for yourself to feed your strikers. A striker's movement to get inside to score goals.
For me, I like scoring goals.
Yeah.
Type of thing, you know? Try to make it. Let's say that's the opposition fullback. You know, I pull out wide and then he's probably looking at the ball. Sometimes you can go, you can kind of like go in front of him.
Yeah.
And I think kind of like, oh, man, I can get the ball.
Yeah.
So when's the right, like,
moment
to do that?
Okay, if you're a winger, and if you're here naturally, right, go. You want to score goals. That's how you're trying to prepare yourself for the game, because you want to score goals. Who doesn't? If you're making a run from here, they're not going to let you.
Okay.
Because the fullback is going to follow you. Fullback is not going to want to make you run. If fullback doesn't follow you, they're going to pull the center back to follow you. And if my center mid has the ball, and they, you know, they're gonna play through ball, where do you think would be smartest way to run?
The smartest way to run? Let's say center mid has the ball there?
Center mid has the ball.
I'd say stay out wide. Kind of
stay out wide.
Yeah.
Look at the offside line. Be the last man. Here's the thing. If you are already here at the offside line, it's dangerous.
Okay.
Right? So you wanna make this run yourself, even though if there's nobody behind you, you wanna make this run here. Like this, you give yourself that forgiveness of 3-4 feet.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because if you don't, if you just start running from here, all it takes for them to go one step forward. that means you're offside now.
Yeah.
Right? So it's very important you make this. Like this. And then go.
And should I be making, when yes. I do check out, try making back?
Yes, you want to make a cross run towards the penalty box, of course, because that's where then you end up wide again. Then you can't score.
Yeah.
Right? Make a run backwards and then go. And if they don't pass it to you, they don't pass it to you. But you tried. You made the proper run.
Instead of looking to, like, from out wide, looking to make that run inside,
yeah.
hold my position,
yes.
just check, and then...
Exactly. Kind of thing. Because you're compacting yourself there,
okay.
and you're making it obvious, and you're actually making them close the central channels.
Okay.
Because if you go here, instead of going out from out wide, mm-hmm. if you go in between the center back and the fullback,
mm-hmm.
you're pulling the center back up, which is ideally, it's the best thing for your team that you can do.
Yeah.
Because you're pulling the center backs, spreading the center backs, you're creating space centrally for your team.
Yeah.
But if you want to score mm-hmm. as a winger,
mm-hmm.
that's the run that you can't make. Because if you come here, naturally, mm-hmm. fullback will come and naturally center back will come,
mm-hmm.
right? So you're going to be compacted here and you can't make that run anymore. If you go make a wide run behind the fullback, you'll have more room to receive the ball and the center mid will have more time to pass it to you and more space to pass it to you. Because now you spread the opposition that way and that way. Because center back
yeah.
thinks fullback has you, that means fullback is dealing with you, right? So center back isn't dealing with you anymore. That means if you make a run behind, there is a gap here for the center mid to send a through ball. You came here,
mm-hmm.
they closed it tight, which is good for your fullback to receive the ball out wide,
yeah.
which is good for your striker to receive the ball centrally, because now you brought fullback and the center back together.
So you know how you said, like, come inside and then make that run in behind? Is
yeah.
that more for like a more central player, like an attacker? Or
yes.
should I be looking to do that too as a winger?
As a winger,
mm-hmm.
it's better to make run backwards. As a striker, doesn't matter. Personally,
okay.
because the center mid will not find the striker right away. Striker will always be like this, right? Always will have the back turn to the opposition, always. And if they're pulling back, that means they already can't turn there. So if striker receives the ball, they will either immediately see the winger or they will see the center mid again. So then your run doesn't really matter as a striker.
Okay.
It really matters what you do as a winger. Because fullback is most likely not gonna be like this to you
yeah.
when you're here. Fullback is more focusing on what your fullback is doing, if they're overlapping, kind of covering this space fullback, most likely,
mm-hmm.
right? A good fullback. If they're really tight to you, then that's good anyways. Because there's lots, your team has tons of room here, but they won't wanna do that. A good fullback will be here. Good fullback will not be very tight to you. Unless you have the ball. When you have the ball, they're gonna be very tight to you. I'm talking specifically about when you don't have the ball as a winger, they're gonna give you your space.
Okay.
As soon as you receive the ball, they're not gonna give you space.
Okay. So what about, let's say, a centimeter, a center back has the ball, and
yeah.
I check into that half space.
Yes.
Maybe play 1-2. Do I then spin? Like, play the pass, and then...
Yes, you can do that.
So let's say a fullback's on me.
Yes, your fullback is on you.
Yeah. I come,
yeah.
bounce, fly, then go.
See, this is where your fullback's overlapping comes
okay.
in hand.
Okay.
I would rather, if I'm coaching your team,
mm-hmm.
I would rather have my fullback up there.
Okay.
I'd rather have you make run over here.
See, yeah.
I take the ball, I can look this way,
uh-huh.
where you made your run there. I can send the through ball to you going that way. Or I can see my fullback again.
Okay.
Now
what
right?
kind of run should I be looking to make? Once I play that,
yeah.
do I make that kind of run or do I just...
That depends where your fullback is.
Okay.
So if your fullback overlapped,
mm-hmm.
I'd rather you go that way.
Okay.
So you came to me,
mm-hmm.
created the space, you spun, and then you go this way, right? So you going this way will create space for my striker.
Okay.
Because I might not see you in this case. Most likely, they will be on to you because you are going to the most dangerous spot, right? So they might forget about my striker. So, or because we have the ball on this side of the field, center backs might come this way, might shift this way. The other side's fullback might shift this way.
Thank you, switch.
Might create a space for my other fullback or winger.
Yep.
But again, as I said in the very beginning of the video,
depends on my fullback.
Really depends what you're communicating with.
Okay.
Because if you're staying wide still after you passed and you went back to open up a space, then maybe my fullback is going centrally. Then I want to see, or my center, other center mid is going centrally. It's all about your communication within the team. How well do you know each other? You don't even have to see where your fullback is making a run to.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't have to see where your striker is making a run to because you already know them very well. You know what they're capable of. You're creating the game according to that. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please drop a like, subscribe to my channel with the notifications on. You can also find the playlist right over here. Thanks for tuning in. I will see you next time.